What's up, ladies and gentlemen? I am your host, Jack Frost Miner, and that was an awful intro. What's up, guys? JFM here. Welcome back to episode 106, I believe, of the subscriber survival. I can't really speak today for some reason. To the survival let's play. All right, so I've got a first. Of course, you guys know the drill. It's time to do the subscriber palace nominations. And here are the subscribers: Keanu Supapo, Maxime LeClaire, Jesus Cardona, and Cody Mitchell. Thank you all for your comments. And I think it's time. Let's go ahead and jump right into today's episode. So I have a few different things planned for today, but I wanted to start off by briefly doing some enchanting. And I have this shovel, which is a really, really, really good shovel, but I really want efficiency on it. So I've brought two of my old diamond shovels that I've used a little bit. Don't know why I didn't finish on them, but I have two, so that's good. But I don't have any lapis. Oh, geez. I'll be right back. All right, let's try that again. So let me go ahead and check it out. Let's see what enchantments we can get. I've got two tries, so I may as well go for it. I'm not level 30. Oh, well, I guess we'll have to do that later. Never mind, I'm not starting I can't do... Oh, you know what? I'll just go get the levels. Be right back. Okay, so worst case scenario, I end up having to enchant twice. Hopefully that doesn't happen. So I've got 6 lapis, 2 shovels, silk touch 1, and efficiency 4 on the first one. There we go. Let's see. What do I get on the next one? Unbreaking. I may as well not even enchant it. So now we've got 2 great shovels. We've got silk touch 1 and unbreaking 3. And if I combine that with the new shovel, I should get, all the enchantments I need on a shovel. So let's take a look. Silk touch 1, unbreaking 3, and efficiency 4. I could use efficiency 5, but there's not gonna be much of a difference on dirt. So what I'll do now is leave this last shovel behind, and I can enchant that one later. It is what it is. So I think that just about does it for the enchantments. Now I've got to show you guys something pretty cool. So guys, here we are. This is the village that I'm working on, and I've got a little bit of progress done. Now I'm actually really annoyed with these villagers because I ended up bringing 2 in here. 2. And they just started repopulating like crazy. So I started off, he's not one. You guys will see, I started off, okay, not you either. Where are my original? No, you're not one either. Okay, hold on. Hey, Blake. Okay, Blake is one of the original ones because I named him. So that's that. And then I think there might... No, you're not. No, who's this? No. Okay, did some of them despawn then? Because I named a few. Hold on. No, here they are. They're just having a house party. So Lou and Dana and Brittany and Blake... Yes, these are the first 4. Now, I believe I started out with 2, and then they started having kids, and I started getting rid of the kids, and then they just kept having kids, and I don't even know. So I was planning to have a village of maybe 6 villagers, and all of them would have names. We got Lou the librarian over here. I think it's actually a priest, but I want him to be a librarian. Dana the doctor. We had Brittany the butcher, I think, and then Blake the blacksmith was the plan, but they just started repopulating like crazy. So I don't know if they've hit their limit because I don't see anyone with hearts anymore, but it's actually annoying. So I think I might just kill a few of them. Okay, I think that's it. So we've got Lou, Dana, Brittany, and Blake here, and I think everybody else... Oh no, we got another twerp running around. Come back here. Well, what's up, guys? Okay, so let me see. Okay, yeah, these are the 4. Now, I'm not sure if they're gonna start breeding again. I assume they will. No, they're just gonna mess around in the house. I don't even know anymore. Okay, so I wanna show you guys what I've been working on. I've been fixing up the wall. I added a wall around just planks, but now, we've got an infected. Oh, sorry about that, bud. Yeah, so I've been adding this wall. Now, the gate I want to make a little bit more grand and a little bit nicer, but for now, it's just those fence gates. But here we go. This is the design of the wall. I created a simple 3x4 or 5 pattern, and I just started repeating it over and over again, and that is how the wall is going to be. So I might do a little speed up here. Oh, here are my supplies. I might do a little speed up And then maybe get a little bit more done, but I'm not gonna do it all just because it is just repetitive. So I'll show you guys a little bit to show you how easy it is. Okay, so we start off with two blocks just like that, and then we can go ahead and go one over and do two stone blocks just like that. Then what we do is we take down this, and then we go up four oak wood logs, and then we place a log facing out, then we put two stone brick stairs just like that, iron bars above it, then we also need stone brick stairs going just like this. And like that, and then I think, yep, I need to add these stone slabs, and then finally, but certainly not least, we have this oak fence here, and that is the design, and then I've also got to jump on top and put a fence up there, but that will go there later. So, now that you've seen the design, I'm going to repeat it a few times, but don't worry, I'm not going to try to bore you, and it will be over very soon. Okay, so I don't know how much of this I'm actually going to show, but I got pretty far. I mean, I wrapped around both of the other houses. I don't know, I really like the way this looks, and I know, oh, whoops, forgot one of these, oh man, oh no, well, I can easily climb up like this, but yeah, I just really like how it looks, and I know it's not efficient, like, I know you could just build up two blocks and call it a day, but I really like the design of this wall, and I don't know, you guys can let me know what you think, but I definitely think it looks cool. It also keeps pretty much everything out, and I think even spiders would have a hard time getting over this. I'm sure they could, especially in some areas like corners, but I don't know if they would be able to get over this part. Because of those, yeah, I don't know. Maybe they would. Easily over this, though. That's for sure. Oh, yeah, they started oh my goodness, they started repopulating already. Who's down here? They've got two kids. Okay, and I still see more hearts. I'm just gonna leave them be. I don't know why they're all hanging out in the house. Oh, it's because it's nighttime. Hold on. They are all just hanging out in the house. Come on, guys. Well, anyways, we'll leave it at that for there. So, as you can tell, I've got the wall going around over to here, and I've also got it going back over to there. So, I've got a little bit more to do, and I'll definitely be able to do the rest of that off camera. Now, I want to show you guys, I've started on this house. I've also finished this house. I just added the, you know, dark oak roof. Oh! Hey, we got one of the squirts out. Awesome. So yeah, as I was saying, I've got some red stained clay up there, dark oak as the roof. I don't know if I like this house too much. I may tear it down and redo it. But I'm fine with it for now, just because it's here, so I may as well keep it until I get the rest of it done. So, yeah, that's the first house. Now, this house, I'm not too sure how I want to do this either, so I might just leave this here for now. It's really simple on the inside, nothing has been added just yet, so I'm gonna leave that like this for now. What I'm going to work on is this house, and I don't like this foundation, so I'm gonna tear it up really quick, and hopefully we can think of something good. Okay, so this is the platform I want to go with. So I'm going to go ahead and take out the ground. I don't believe I'm actually going to have enough of the hardened clay for this. So I may have to just substitute some grass in. I mean, it looks similar, so I'll use it for now. But let me see where. Okay, 25 green stained clay. I highly doubt it's going to do it. But maybe once I furnish the inside, maybe I'll be able, yeah, okay, so right now, I'm gonna have to put some grass on the inside of the house. I will change this later, but just for looks, for now, for the sake of the video, I'll add that. You know what, it doesn't look that bad, actually. It's kind of cool. Now, I'm gonna take everything on this up by three. So I'm gonna do this, or no, up by two to make it three tall. So I'll do that, I'll do this, and I'll do this all the way around. I had exactly the right amount of planks and logs to finish that. Do I have anything? Okay, I had three extra planks hidden in there, but yeah, okay. So there we go. Also, I'm actually going to be punching out windows here. So there's gonna be a window. Whoa, wait a second. Huh. Never mind, we're good. Just put two windows there, a window here, and then I'm assuming we put a window here. We'll put one there for now, and then we'll have a window. Wait, let me do a door here. Yeah, there we go. A door there, and then a window just like that. So a three-wide window. Then over here, we'll just make this one big window. I think. I think that'll look good. So, on the outside, similar to that other house, I'm going to be adding, little flower pot holders just like this using spruce stairs that I place upside down, and then over here, I think I'll do them like that. Yeah, that'll be good. Around this side, I'll put them here and here, and then over here, I'll probably just put, one each right there. So that should be good. Now it's time to put in the flowers! So I've got some tulips, I've got this awesome blue orchid, that's probably my favorite flower in the game. I've got some poppies, a white tulip over here, we'll maybe add an oxeye daisy right there, and then maybe another poppy over here, add one of these epic blue orchids, and then finish it off with maybe a red tulip right there, and I think that's the last one. Alright, I'll put the rest back. Okay, so now that we've got all of this situated, by the way, I switched the door. I'd rather have it over here, so, yeah, I moved the door over here. But now that we've got all of that situated, I think it's time to start adding some of the interior design. Now, I've got all of the blocks I'm going to need, so let me go ahead and start designing. So I'll have a cauldron here, and I'll have a note block there. I'll have water in the cauldron. I think that'll be cool. Also, I'm going to have an area over in the other direction with a nice little, I don't know what you would call it, dining area, I suppose? So check it out. What I'm gonna use here is I'm going to go ahead and use a redstone torch and a piston to set up a table. Probably should put a plank there, because I think I might be able to see that. Let me check. So if I put this piston down, yeah, you can sort of see it back there. So yeah, make sure you have a plank there. Now I'm also going to be adding some stairs here. Oh wait, do I want these? No, I thought I had other ones. Do I have any other stairs? No, I don't. I was gonna- oh yeah, I do. I was gonna use these dark oak ones. I really like the dark oak wood stairs, so there we go. That's what I'm going to use there. Then I'm going to put item frames on the side, so that should look good. And I also need to add some books. Oh, I grabbed the bookshelves already. Okay, I'm already ahead of the game. So, oh, they're already out here. Okay, I can place the bookshelves up there for a nice little educated eating session. And what else? Okay, I also have a few furnaces in here. I think that would look nice. So let me go ahead and place these furnaces down. I guess this is the kitchen area. And then, I don't know, maybe I'll have something right there, and then, okay, yes, I do have this stone brick slab, perfect, so place that right there, then maybe have a nice little mushroom, chilling out right there. I like that. Some good interior design action right there. And then I think to finish it off, we'll place a crafting table and an anvil right there. So I think that should be just about it. I don't know if there's anything else. I mean, this is pretty packed. I don't know, maybe I could add something right here. We'll work on that later, but now I want to show you guys what really, I'm really excited about this house. Let's go ahead and show you. Let's get it started. I'm going to make a farm outside. I'm going to make a little garden out in the back. Now, I would probably, now that I'm thinking about it, wheat doesn't really make sense. Probably should have done carrots, because nobody really has a small little wheat farm in their backyard, but hey, this person will. So, I guess I'm just going to make a small enclosure for this area. I didn't really plan this out too well, so we'll just see. Maybe it cuts in right there, then goes out a little bit more, and then that cuts in right there. Yeah, okay, I think that'll look good. Looks nice and natural. I've also got a bucket of water to go ahead and place that down. Now I can till all of the land and add the seeds in. I'm not sure. Yeah, there's definitely not going to be 18 spots here. It's going to be a very small wheat farm. It's not the size of the farm that counts. So we'll go ahead and do that. Maybe call it a day there. And then once this grows, I think it'll actually look pretty cool. We can add a nice little path here with the shovel. I think that looks good. And I also want to add a path out in front of the houses as well. So let's go ahead and get this done too. Ooh. Ooh, I like it. Then we can go ahead and place our doors as well. So now we've got functioning doors. So I think the villagers will actually come in here now. I may need to place glass and stuff, but I think, well, yeah, let me go ahead and get some sand. Look at how cool this thing looks from the distance. That is awesome. It's got a chimney on this house as well. I didn't really give a proper tour. There was just too many people inside. So maybe if I think people have left now that it's daytime, I'm assuming. So while this stuff is cooking in a furnace, I can probably show you the interior. It looks as if the repopulation has slowed down a little. No, it hasn't. Oh my goodness, look at all these new people. They're still in here. Okay, so we've got a storage system right here, a chimney from the furnace. Now, it's funny because on the outside, the chimney's on this side, but it is what it is. Over here, we've got a bed and a crafting table. There's not much on the inside. This one, I'm not sure if I like this house too much, and there are way too many people in there. I think I may do a quick little extermination of these two people. There we go. Okay. Now I'm gonna head over here and continue working on this house. Perfecto. We have 6 pieces of glass, which I believe is enough to make, yes, 16 glass panes. That is absolutely wonderful. So let's go ahead and get these placed. I think 16 ought to be enough. Now, guys, today I'm not going to be doing the roof because roofs take so much time and it usually takes a lot of trial and error as well. So I'll leave the roof for later. But for now, I'd say this house is looking pretty nice. I may actually add a second floor now that I'm thinking about it. No, I think this is all we need. Hey, we've got an inhabitant. Awesome. Oh, we've got 2 inhabitants. Hey, Lou's here. That's awesome. I love it. I absolutely love it. So looks as if they're having a little bit of fun in this house, I'd say. Very, very pleased. Now, I also want to leave because there's more to do today, fellas. There is more to do. I've also got to finish up this house and that house, and I'll continue working, but you guys get the basic gist of what I'm doing here. I'm just building houses and making a village for these guys. So, some of you may have seen this central area and said, "What? Why did you put this plus here?" Well, I will explain it to you. This is a 9 by 9 plus. So this is going to be the center of this little town. Now, it's not actually the center, but this is going to be the marketplace. I'm gonna have a few market stalls over here, and hopefully it'll work out well. So I just wanted to mark it right there, just to see how big the radius would be. I believe I have materials. Yes, I have plenty of market materials in here. So let me go ahead, grab what I'm gonna be using for the floor. I'll probably be using a mix between gravel and cobblestone. I'm not exactly sure how I want it just yet, so I'm just gonna basically make an outline, and hopefully this ends up looking good. Okay, so that is the area of the market, I think. So what's gonna happen is I'm going to go ahead and start placing some blocks in here. Now, I want it to be very heavy in the middle, and then on the outside, there'll be a little bit more grass peeking in. So, like, the busiest part is going to be the middle, and then out here, there's going to be a very few other blocks other than grass. I'm definitely not explaining this right. There we go. So hopefully now that makes a little sense. So it looks busy in the middle, and then on the outside it kind of just gets a little bit less worn, and then that is where the market stalls are going to be. Now, I'll probably extend this pathway out to the beginning and over to a few of the houses, and then make the pathways like this pressed dirt stuff out into the market. So let's go ahead and do this really quick. Extend this out to the market area, and then it's going to turn into a little bit of gravel and stone. So I think that is how I'm going to do it, and so far I really like the way this stuff looks. Now for the market stalls. So I think I'll put one right here. I think that'll be a good idea. So we'll have one that goes just like this. We'll have it go out like that. There's going to be a gate maybe in the side or the back. Yeah, the gate will be in the back. That's how I'll do it. So this is going to be like a counter, so you'll be able to display items for people to buy right up here. And then I'll have the gate in the back. There'll still be a few counters, but I'll have a gate in the middle. And I guess I'll make that out of a trap door. Haven't really thought about it. Yeah, a trap door would be cool. And then, of course, we're gonna use some wool for the top of the market stall. Now, I was planning on using just one color, but I'm thinking maybe I should mix some white in. So I'm not exactly sure if this is the best idea. Oh boy, we've got an Enderman. That's no fun. Let me go ahead and get this set up. I think I'm getting inspired by the LBSG server that has this. I think I'm just gonna make it like that. So we'll see how it goes. Okay, you know what? I'm fine with it. I definitely like it. So this is one of the market stalls. Now I am going to have to get rid of this guy. He is going to terrorize the wall. You need to leave, sir. There we go. Okay, so I think that's it for that one. Now I don't want them all to be the same size. So maybe I have, well, you know what? Actually, there's not a lot of room here. There's not a lot of room. I was hoping to have more. Let's put maybe another one right. That chest is in the way. Hey, Someone's selling stuff. Oh, Lou, you are awesome. So Lou has decided to take over this stall. Good for him, good for him. I'm going ahead and making some smaller ones. So the red one is the biggest. And then I have this orange one right here that's a little bit smaller. Kind of looks a little weird, but I think it fits the size of this village much, much more. So we'll leave that. And I think Lou has already given up. Yeah, I don't think he couldn't sell enough. He's already gone. So, oh, that's actually bad. Did the Enderman do that? That should not be there. Okay, so I'm gonna continue finishing up this last one, and okay, whoops, didn't mean to do that. You know what? I think that's fine. I think this is a fine marketplace. So we've got some vendors over here that have yet to have nobody's wanting to sell stuff, but at least it's there, you know, just in case someone wants to sell some of their goods. Once someone starts taking over that wheat farm, they're gonna have some stuff to sell. So you know what? It's fine. It's fine. I may add some sort of fountain here in the middle, or maybe, you know what, you know it would be really cool to have like wagons in the middle or wheelbarrows or something like that. But with these houses, I think these four houses will be fine, and you know, they'll have the shops out here, they'll have a nice little town. I'm actually really stoked about this. Yeah, like I could use like item frames. I'm gonna put some hay bale in here. So maybe this guy is selling hay bales, maybe, and then maybe he's selling something in this flower pot. Not too sure. We'll just add some random clutter around here. Just put stuff in random spots. I think that looks good. So yeah, well, you know what, guys? We're just gonna have a nice little area, and then like, you know what? There could be like a no. I don't want to have it so someone could climb over. So I'll leave that the way it is. But yeah, so this is going to be really cool. Now I'll continue working on this. May add some white wool up in there to make it look nice, but we are going to have a nice little village over here, and I'm really excited for it. The only downside is these guys seem to be repopulating like crazy and only hanging out in one house. So, are they still in here? Yeah. Yeah, they are. They definitely are. Okay, I'll leave them be. So, I guess they like that one. I can't really take it down if they're all inside. So, yeah, I guess that's it. So, here we go. A good view overlooking the town. I'll leave it here for today. Thank you guys so, so, so much for watching. And as always, stay frosty, my friends. Peace, guys. See ya. Bye-bye.